Now we will talk about programming in Unreal Engine and how we can control our meshes or our actors or characters and determine its behavior. In Unreal Engine there are two systems you can control with it, Blueprint and C++. Blueprint is a visual scripting system in Unreal Engine and you can completely control your game with it. In C++ you can code and also you can use with it a blueprint. Here now we will start with blueprint. We will choose blank, desktop, maximum quality and with starter content and rename our project for blueprint demo. In this video we will create a 3 spotlight and control its behavior by using blueprints. Let's start in content folder, create a new folder called blueprints and open it. Right click and create a blueprint class. I'll choose here actor and double click onto it. It opened us the editor. From here we will add a component that we will control. So I will choose spotlight for example and rename it for spotlight 1. Select it, come to front view and define a rotation for it to down like this. Save. Here you will find a properties of that light, intensity, light color and so on. This is the default values. These values, if we come to the second one, construction script, it will construct or create a spotlight with intensity and light color is white and so on. Okay, if we want to change this value, if we want to create a light with a blue color when it creates on the screen, how can we change this behavior programmatically from construct script? So put a node to control the light intensity. So I will search for intensity, set intensity of the spotlight, something like this, and I will change a new intensity to, here is 5000, I will make it 50,000 or 40,000. This node can control the light intensity or change the value of these details, but programmatically. This node need an input of target which is a spotlight and need a value which is the intensity. Okay, now we can save. We need also to make its color as a blue. So I will search for, we can search for light color and here is get light color and a function also is set light color. Well, here we will use set light color to set a value to a color. Make it away. This node set light color need a target value which is a spotlight and new light color. Double click on this square and by picker choose the new color you want to change like this. And finally connect our input from here. So we construct our light, it will set the intensity with the value 40,000 and then after finish it will construct or set the light color to blue. Save, compile, come down to our screen. Now we don't want directional light in the screen, we want it black like this, and come to front and drag our new blueprint spotlight like this. Come closer, check it from the top at the middle of the screen. Okay, come to perspective. Here we play, it will come to a new blue light in the screen, and this is will be the first step in blueprint. If we double click onto it again, delay the light for 2 seconds before it construct. So come to event graph and then begin play. When the play begin, wait 2 seconds or delay for 2 seconds before construct the light. So search for delay function here, and this delay duration by seconds, I will make it 2 seconds delay. And after the delay is complete, set the visibility of light to on. So So visibility search for visibility, set visibility of spotlight this new visibility will be on. Okay, and come to construction. When construct, make the visibility first off. So search for visibility again and search for set visibility this, like, and make the new visibility off to visibility and continue our chart like this way. This mean when the light come on the screen or build it on the screen, set the visibility to none, there is no visibility off, and make the intensity with these values. And when the play start after 2 seconds, set the visibility on, save and compile, come back to our screen and press play 1, 2 and then the light on. Okay, now let's start make this light toggle on and off and on and off. First let's make it a little bigger of this, so I will change the scale of the light to 4 x y and z. Search for start and let's make the start in front of light here, something like this. Double click onto blueprint, and now we want to make this light toggle on and off. Okay, here, okay, the play begin, it will delay 2 seconds and then the visibility will be on. We will delay again, we will delay again for 1/2 second and then we will set visibility, we will set visibility again to off. And after a delay for 1/2 second, after a delay for 1/2 second, we will make the visibility on again. Look at the shape. Now we have something like loop here. Visibility on, delay 1/2 second, visibility off, delay 1/2 second, visibility on, and so on. Save, compile. Let's run here and see what's happened. Start a game. 2 seconds after, it will on, off, on, off, on, off, and so on. Close. Let's run and see in the game. 1, 2, then on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. Okay. Come back to blueprint file and make 2 copies of n. Control C, Control V, Control C, Control V again. It will create a 2 copies. The first one, press F2 and rename it for blue spot blueprint. The second one, press F2 on keyboard, red spot blueprint. The third one, F2 on keyboard, green spot blueprint. Press Enter. Come to the green spot, double click into it. Come to construction script and come to set light color, double click into it, choose bigger and choose green color, press OK, save, compile, close it, come to red spot, come to construction and come to the set light color, choose bigger and choose red, press OK, save, compile again, close, come to left view and drag our green light and drag our red light, something like this. Save and run, play, red and green and blue, but play in the same time. So we want the blue first, then the green, then the red. Change the time. So go to the green, go to the event graph and make the delay 2.3 seconds. Save, compile, close. Go to the red spot event graph and make the duration 2.6. After it, 2.6. Save, compile. Play. Nice. Now we will talk about another type of blueprint. It's called level blueprint. Come here and open level blueprint. Each level have a blueprint special for it and contain a global behavior to a specific level. This node event begin play. When the play begin, we want to spawn a sound at a certain location. We will put a sound to the game to make a sound with the light. Here we want to select the sound asset for this content folder. I will create a new folder for audio. I will bring my new asset, my new sound, like this, and save and drag it into audio and move. Okay, return back to our blueprint, level blueprint, and select our asset. When the level is start, this sound will play. Select it and press C on keyboard for command and rename it for play sound for of level and compile, close, open our screen and let's start the level. We reach the end of our lesson. If you found this video is helpful, please like and subscribe. Thank you.